hygiene in order to flush out excess sebum is an important preventive measure to maintain a healthy scalp area. The scalp, like any part of the skin, requires careful hygiene. The use of balms and conditioners for the hair shaft is very important in balancing the negative charge of shampoos and maintaining the healthy structure of the hair follicle. Special soaps sold in pharmacies for hair are also very valuable. Choose the right hair care product. Shampoo or balm that's not suitable for you will damage the structure of the roots, and over time, the hair will begin to fall out. Therefore, use shampoos or balms that are suitable for your hair type and rich in natural ingredients. Any chemical agents have a damaging effect on the hair structure. Frequent hair coloring and chemical treatment of hair can also lead to the weakening of hair shaft and poor hair health. Wash your hair 24-48 hours before coloring it. That's what you should know before you dye your hair in the first place. Second day hair develops enough natural oils that help the dye bind to it better. Apply conditioner designed for color-treated hair. In fact, dyeing kits usually include conditioners. Brushing and rough rubbing with a towel will injure wet hair and can cause some of the growing hair to fall out and break off. Using a hair dryer also damages the follicles, as it dries out the skin and its structures in addition to the hair. It weakens hair proteins. Avoid heat styling your hair. This includes flat ironing, straightening, blow drying, and curling your hair. These things can make your hair look dull. With regular use, over time, they can cause permanent damage. Hair may be weak when it's wet. It's therefore recommended to avoid brushing wet hair. Brushing hair too frequently can injure hair and increase hair loss. After washing your hair, dry it gently by wrapping it or squeezing it with a towel, rather than rubbing it vigorously with one. Wait for your hair to dry a bit before brushing it. When you brush it, use a wide tooth comb. Don't overbrush your hair. Brushing your hair too much can actually cause split ends and breakage. You also need to be careful about what kind of brush or comb you use. Wide tooth combs are commonly recommended by stylists as the most gentle option. Sparse round tooth wooden comb or a naturally fluffy brush that's long but not too stiff are most suitable for combing when hair loss is increased. Do not always comb your hair in the same direction. Sleeping with moist hair also results in more hair loss. Therefore, care should be taken to dry the hair after washing. Avoid overwashing your hair. Washing your hair too often robs your hair and scalp of their natural oils and dry your hair out. Washing your hair too vigorously can also cause damage. So be gentle. You can wash your hair once, twice, or three times a week. It's recommended to wash your hair with lukewarm water. Regular massaging of the scalp may increase blood circulation in the scalp and help you to relax and improve scalp health. Thinning hair is a reality for a large percent of men, with risks increasing as we age. If you start noticing your hair thinning, cut it short. It will always look better than long hair. Shorter hair holds volume better and will give the illusion that there is more than there is. When hair lays flat to the head, it actually exposes more scalp. It's not recommended to apply any masks on the scalp without knowing the exact cause of hair loss and consulting a specialist. As a result, masks can damage the scalp and cause hair bleaching. By following the tips I mentioned, you can keep your hair healthy and beautiful. And I wish you success in this work. I invite you to click the like button of the video, share it, and subscribe to my channel. Bye!